Oh, it does smell good, doesn't it? Hello YouTube, it's Dry Neck Dave here, and today I'm on the River Chelmer again, up in Chelmsford Town Centre, in what is undoubtedly one of the smelliest parts of this river I've ever had to put my boat into, but we're moving, I'm out, we're getting there. So I'm out again today with my my brother Mick, who's just there. Alright Mick, how's it?
Alright,
caught anything yet? I've got my Polaroids, I didn't bring them, so annoyed myself. Right, but I've got my little telescopic rod with me. My legs are covered in duckweed, which is really, really pleasant. Don't want to get into these guys' lines, we'll stay over there, don't we? I'm quite happy if we stop moving. We need to get back under that bridge. It's a structure, isn't it?
Thank you.
come further upstream, and we're actually in Chelmsford town centre itself, driving up towards the ground. See if we can't get something up there. But yeah, it's not been good so far, to be honest. Like hypodermics floating in the river. Seen a few carp though, which wasn't expected. Yeah, it's been a bit, to say the least, so far. Right, Mick.
There you go.
We're having a blow.
Chair,
oh, right. Oh, Mick Yoga there. He's having a cup of tea. So I thought while I'm sitting waiting, I'll chuck this lure back to the first couple of times. And cheeky little Jack just came up and hammered it as I was bringing it out of the boat. But he didn't look up, so I'm going to keep chucking it through because he's there. You never know, I might get lucky and have him out. Right, going for a bit of change tactics now. I'm going to use a sprat. It's going to loop hook it underneath this float, which I'm going to just drop off the edge of the kayak. So we can't arouse some interest from something. And trust me, you're going to be so glad that this ain't smelly vision right now, because these sprats have seen better days, trust me. Bath for a week. That smell ain't coming off. But that's what we want, stinky baits. Day's fishing I was expecting. We really need to get some light baits, and I haven't brought the necessary gear out to catch them. And I did have a little bit of an effort with a net to try and net some, but they were tiny, tiny little fry, which might work on perch, but I don't even think I've got hooks small enough to try with. So I need to think properly next time about fishing first for live baits. get a few of those and then start perch pike fishing. So we've stopped off and we're actually in the middle of Chatsworth town centre. Through there's the cinema. Look, we've got Wilco's, and apparently over the back there somewhere is a McDonald's. Well, so my brother Mick's just gonna get coffees. But it's just I can't believe how much life there is, and you should have a look at it down here. All them roach. Loads of them. So that's really what we need, some of them. Put some live baits in, catch a few pike, but the opportunity's not come up. So we're just gonna carry on what we're doing. Move back down, see if we can't get into anything. So we've come back to the big weir under the bridge that we walked across earlier on, and basically tied up underneath the bridge. And what we're hoping is if it's a bit darker under it, they might be more inclined to have a go at striking a bait, but I think it's far too bright now. I think it's going to push them down and put them right off. So if you can see that behind me, I've got dead bait, just float, sprat underneath it, and dropping some jellies about, see if we can get anything on them. So that's all we can do. We'll see what happens. Stay tuned. Move to another spot on the far bank. Been a lot of fish shown on top over here, like roach and stuff, and it's absolutely alive with fish over here. Now, we were talking to a guy who's fishing on the bank over there earlier, and he was telling us that last night, or yesterday afternoon on this bank, from about 2 o'clock onwards, he said the perch were just chasing fish up and down this bank all night long, and right into the night. So what I'm gonna do is just have a little peepy under with this, and see we've got moping around in here. Just wish we had some live baits, but I'm kind of always like of the opinion that you don't need to use live baits, because you know there's always plenty of artificial baits and stuff out there, but if it's the only thing that's going to catch your fish, you've got to go with it. It's I don't know, here it is. I've just got fish swirling around, shoals of roach. See, because I've dumped myself over here, they've all moved out now. Now, I haven't seen a perch. Mickey reckons he's had a little jack and he was dropping his bait on its nose, but he couldn't really see it very well, so it could have been a chub. But he just stood there and looked at it, he didn't take the lure, so it might have been a twig. Now, him, log, who knows? But I trust his judgment. If he says it was a jack pike, my my lure here. Fine.